Usually, left or right bundle branch block pattern is persistent on ECG. But there are cases when bundle branch block occurs only at higher heart rate. Bundle branch block is characterized by impaired conduction via the left or right bundle branch. Rate-dependent bundle branch block is characterized by appearance only at the certain heart rate, and it disappears at the heart rate below this value, also known as critical heart rate. Usually, heart rate, at which there is transition between the normal conduction and the bundle branch block, is about 100 beats per minute. In this case, the term of tachycardia-dependent bundle branch block is used. But also, such heart rate at which such transition is observed may be at the normal range. In other words, bundle branch block occurs when the heart rate exceeds some limit which is at a range from 60 to 100 beats per minute. The term of the exercise-induced bundle branch block is close to the term of rate-dependent bundle branch block. It may be explained by the fact that the heart rate increases upon physical exertions. It's established that exercise-induced left bundle branch block is 3 times more frequent than exercise-induced right bundle branch block. But rate-dependent bundle branch block appears at the rest in contrast to exercise-induced one. Left bundle branch block may be caused by a block either in the main left bundle branch, so-called pre-divisional, or by a simultaneous block in both anterior and posterior fascicles, so-called post-divisional. Mechanism of rate-dependent bundle branch block is based on prolongation of the refractory period in cells of the conductive system of the ventricles. Cells in the refractory period cannot conduct an impulse. So in the case of rate-dependent left bundle branch block, impulse is conducted firstly via the right bundle branch. In the case of rate-dependent right bundle branch block, impulse is conducted firstly via the left bundle branch. Impulse cannot be conducted via the bundle branch if the heart rate exceeds the limit at which conduction is normal. If heart rate is higher, the interval between impulses is shorter, and cells with a prolonged refractory period have not enough time to restore the conductibility. When the heart rate is lower, cells have time to go out from the refractory period and they conduct the impulse. Rate-dependent bundle branch block is associated with chronic hypertension, previous myocardial infarction, coronary artery disease, and myocarditis. Rate-dependent bundle branch block may be the first sign of coronary artery disease. At this ECG, we can see the left bundle branch block occurring at a heart rate of 68 beats per minute and more. This is a critical heart rate. If heart rate is higher than this value, the left bundle branch block is obligatory. At heart rate less than 68 beats per minute, there is normal conduction in the ventricles. Often, supraventricular exosystole creating a compensatory pause give time for the conductive tissue to go out from the refractory period, and such exosystole terminates episode of the left bundle branch block. If the heart rate is still frequent, exosystole can provide the normal conduction of only one impulse that follows this exosystole. If such patient has paroxysmal supraventricular tachycardia, left bundle branch block pattern during it is observed. It should be noted that the bundle branch block may deteriorate heart failure because of an asynchronic contraction of all walls of the ventricle. Lowering of heart rate may improve conduction via rate-dependent block bundle branch and thus improve asystolic function of the ventricles. Thank you for watching this video. We hope you enjoyed it. If you want to see more of our videos, please subscribe and hit the like button.